In this tutorial, I'll show you how to implement shadow maps for spotlights and point lights in OpenGL. If you don't already know how to implement shadow maps for directional lights, then I highly recommend watching my previous tutorial, since otherwise this won't make much sense. So let's first implement the shadows for spotlights, since they are a lot easier than point lights. All we really have to do is to replace the orthographic projection with a perspective projection, and then add the shadow map code to the spotlights. It's essentially identical to the directional lights one. The only thing you might want to change is the bias limit, since spotlights have a precise location and so will get you high quality maps, as opposed to directional lights, where you may end up with a low quality map if you don't fit them properly. Basically, you just want to increase the precision of the biases in order to get proper shadows. Now for the more complicated shadow map for point lights. You could technically just use 6 spotlights for each side of a cube, but then you would have 6 render calls to get all the shadow maps. Instead of doing that, we could use a cube map and a geometry shader, which will allow us to render all 6 faces in a single draw call. So let's first create the frame buffer object and the cube map for it. Don't forget to attach the cube map to the frame buffer and tell OpenGL that it won't be drawing to the color buffer. Now we want to create the perspective matrices for all 6 views, so we'll start off by creating the default perspective matrix. Make sure it has an FOV of 90 degrees so that it covers exactly one face of a cube. Then we'll want to create an array where we store all 6 of our final matrices. Make sure your up vectors are not parallel with the direction you look towards. Now we'll want to create 3 shaders for the shadow maps. For the vertex shader, we'll simply want to output the position of all vertices. For the geometric shader, we'll want to input and output 6 triangles at the same time, one for each side of the cube map. Also make sure you import those matrices we just made. Then you'll want to loop over all 6 faces, and for each one transform all vertices to the respective face and create a triangle. And for the last shader, the fragment shader, you want to import the light position and the value of the far plane, then manually calculate the depth and linearize it between 0 and 1. Don't forget to also create a shader program for these 3 shaders and then export all the uniforms they need. The next step is to draw the cube map, bind it, and export it right before drawing the scene normally. Make sure to use GL Texture Cube Map and not GL Texture 2D like last time. Be sure to import the texture as a sampler cube uniform, not a sampler 2D uniform. As for the shadow algorithm itself, we'll do something extremely similar to last time. We'll start off with a shadow of 0 and then calculate the vector from the fragment to the position of the light. By taking the length of this vector, we get a current depth. Then we want to create a bias just like last time, and keep in mind this will likely be more similar to the directional one rather than the spotlight one. Now in order to get nice soft shadows, you want to loop over all nearby coordinates of the cube map and check if they are in shadow or not. The last step is to average the shadow, and finally add the shadow variable to the return. If you now run the program, you should have some nice soft shadows generated by a point light. Don't forget to check out my Discord channel and Patreon, and as always, the source code and all sources and resources used are in the description. Bye!